Hey guys, Jeremy Toy here, ninja400r.com, here with another one of our test bed bikes in the lovely facility of Hot Bodies Racing. Obvious being Hot Bodies Racing, we're going to do some body work today. All right, now with all body work, resist the temptation to send the stuff out and get it painted first. You definitely want to mount, have all your holes taken care of, and everything lining up correctly before you pay money to have it painted. So don't be fooled. This is actually one of the Hot Bodies green gel coats. These come in a couple different colors. This one looking like it's painted, but this is actually the way it comes out of the box. So let's go ahead and start with our holes. Hot Bodies now is coming with the holes pre-drilled. Just for reference, they won't be to spec because everybody's going to use a different fastener. You might use a Zeus. Some of the guys will use, you know, nuts and bolts to put the lowers together. Some of the midsections you use a pop pin. So merely for reference sake, but a good reference on where you should go. So always start with connecting the upper and lower together. We are going to use traditional Zeus fasteners for this. So we'll start with the outside section, which on this particular bike is the upper, and drill that to the exact size of the Zeus itself. So should be at just get that to where it just goes through. Lines up nice. Okay, moving on to the upper here, another oddity about this bodywork is the dash actually holds the gauges. So, again, we're going to have to use the bodywork pre-drilled holes just as a reference point. There's a few holes around there. I'm assuming that is for, you know, the different countries or whatever, but we're going to use a 3 that's started. We're going to drill it to a little over 14 mil to receive the rubber grommet that holds your speedometer in the stock place. Size that you see, that's where the plug will come through to attach your speedometer. So we're going to go ahead and drill that out. That one's not exact size. You can kind of make it to wherever. You might want to make it a little bigger than the recess shows, just because it'll be a little easier to attach and detach your speedometer when you're taking it on and off.
with the three holes drilled for the speedometer and a good size port for the gauge plug. Go ahead and put our rubber grommets in there. Go ahead and feed those through and work them in there. Small screwdriver, something a little blunt, so you don't tear the rubber. Double check it's nice and round. Make it easier when you're putting your speedometer in. Nice and clean. Let's go ahead and put our speedometer in there. Good little thing to use is some silicon spray, something like a Maxima SC1, or even, you know, any type of polish you might have laying around. It'll just make that thing lube up in and receive it easier.
There you go. Speedometer mounted. First vision of the race bike.
Okay. On this particular lower, it doesn't come fully drilled. This lower actually is set up to run with stock bodywork if you want. So it will have an extra hole in here. I'm not too sure on the other manufacturers, but probably pretty common. So it's going to have three holes for race bodywork and for Zeus fasteners. We're just going to use the two outside ones. It's more than enough that than what you will need. And let's go ahead and open those up. This also being the outside, so just to the side, just to the size of the nut or the bolt itself, the drive part of the Zeus fastener. Basically, what I'm doing is counting the steps on the uni bit. If you were going to use individual bits, you just measure the size and then blast through it. All right, double check that we all got the right size in there. All right, let's grab those mids and connect them. Basically, what we've done now is we've opened up all of our holes, with starting with the outside of the upper, which is the outside, and the outside of the lower, which is the outside that's going to connect to this mid piece. We're going to verify that we're all lined up on holes. We don't need to do any mods or trimming, that the holes are all square and true. And then once you verify that, you're going to put the two outside pieces, which is your upper and your lower on this specific bike. All right, so both mids on this bike are going to have the receiving part of the Zeus fastener on there. That needs to be opened up big enough for that collar part of the receiver in there. So now we know all these holes are lined up. Go ahead and drill that big enough. Just like that. So basically, it just centers that nice and true. Gives it a little bit better of a mounting position. You know, over time, you're gonna be popping those things in and out. The rivets are obviously held in there
up against the fiberglass, everything will start to wear on itself, so it's better to have a little bit more surface area to be supportive. To speed this measurement up a little bit, just taking a Sharpie on my uni bit and made a little mark there so I can just cruise right up to it. All right, we are good on that side. So with the Zeus fastener, go ahead and line it up inside of that hole. Feel it drop into its spot right there. Get it nice and square. Sharpie. Make ourselves a little mark. Pull that back. See if we've got a spot to drill. Get it started. Make sure and stick your fingers right behind the drill bit. And you probably want to get a drill bit that's a little bit sharper than that one. Another cool thing about using the bodywork box as a table, you can drill the heck out of it and not worry about scratching anything. So back to the Zeus fastener, the receiver part, doesn't really matter which way it goes, but one thing I do is I'll mount each one per after I've drilled it. Some of the bodywork has contours on it, and I'll show you in like this one right here, we're going to bend the tabs to fit nice and flush. So let me get my rivet gun. All right. Line up that fastener. Flip it over. Don't really have to rub it down, but just go ahead and stick that in. Nice fit. Key here is to hold the side of the Zeus fastener down flush with the bodywork as you're tightening the rivet, especially if you're using a ratchet type rivet. These pneumatic ones are a little quicker, but still hold it down nice and tight. Easy as that. First, we're going to get a fail right off the bat. This thing's going to protest. And then we'll go to this side. Alright, now, again, hold that thing down nice and flush. There, we've got a perfect Zeus fastener. Hey, that was easy. Five more of those and we'll be done.
You know, it's only a matter of time.
All right, here we go on the side with a little bit of attitude. Obviously, you can see the bodywork has a curvature right there. You want it to match your other Zeus, but doesn't fit flush. Try and put that thing in with any rivets. The thing will just get cattywampus over it the first couple times and take flight. So what we're going to do, seeing how it curves up here on the end, take a pair of pliers, if you have a really small vise, something like that, just put a couple degrees of bend in that thing. And then after you do that, put a couple more degrees of bend into that thing. Just like that. You see how perfectly that contours the body work now? Same deal with highly technical Sharpie marker. Make sure that thing drops into the hole nice and tidy. Don't want it walking around. Press it nice down really good. Mark our spot. Two holes to receive this drill. I know we talked about getting a little bit sharper one, but we're at a time crunch. All right, two holes for the rivets. All right, let's start by popping these rivets through. We're gonna pop the one, and then on the contoured side, with that lined up, we'll pop that one. Just like that. Again, push down tight. Fingers get tired after a while. Use something metal. Go nice and contoured, Zeus. All right, we got five Zeus fasteners later, and a lot of patience. We've got two midsections with real nice Zeus fasteners, all pointing the same direction, all nice and straight, all nice and flush. Before this goes on the bike, let's just double check everything's aligned with the upper and the lower. All right, with all four pieces Zeused together, things nice and tidy, everything went together pretty nice. Found one little section on the leading edge corners of one of the pieces right there that, to make it mount rot freer and just pop that mid in, I'm gonna take a little nick off of the corner of it, not really changing the structure of it, but just make it so it so it definitely is easier to mount. One, there's a little bit of runoff on this particular piece. I don't know if you can see that, but I'm going to just trim it back so it fits in there nice and tidy and is a little bit more flush. So basically, rule of thumb is mount your body work up, even to the bike, before you start trimming stuff, because as soon as you line the holes up, the body work will shift a little bit and a lot of time align itself. But you don't want to make any modifications until you know that the thing's bolted up correctly. And this right now is, we're just bolting it up to itself, so we're just going to deal with that portion of it. This being the mid right here, we're going to take just that little tiny part of the edge off. It'll fit nicer into the lower and be a lot easier when you're putting the lower on.
That sounds good.
And this sharp edge right there, kind of same thing. Just kind of rounding the edges so when we go to pop the lower on, it pops on without any struggle or effort.
Much, much better.
All right, a nice barrel sander like that gives you a nice finish. It's easy to take material away, nice and quick. Basically, you just want to take these sharp edges off the thing. It'll make it mount nice and tight.
That's what we're going for here.
Yeah! something like that. Real simple. Makes it easier when you're at the track.
All right, now we're happy with our upper, mid, lower mount. Let's go ahead and put this stuff on the bike. Goofy thing with this bike, starts with the mid.
That's absolutely true.
Normally any other bike, you would definitely start with the upper first, work your way down, but because the multiple pieces of bodywork on this bike, you start with the mid, that's the back piece. So with those holes that are already aligned, have them drilled at least to fit your stock 4mm bolts in there. We'll use that just to hang this stuff. Try and use a collar bolt. Basically, we're gonna go ahead and mount this thing as this without. And just pretend it's got a collar on it. Simple as that.
That was easy.
You'll definitely want to make some type of bracket or zip tie this away from your throttle, possibly do wiring harness there and to the back of the air box with the two fuse boxes. You don't want these things flopping around. Definitely don't want them interfering with your throttle cable. So zip tie those things back or make yourself a nice little aluminum bracket.
All right, got a view of the front of the bike here. Make everything nice and tidy. What we're gonna do is grab our turn signals, the wires of that. We'll go ahead and zip tie them up to the harness itself. On this side over here, you've got your tip over switch. Obviously, do not remove that. And if you do, you need to make a bracket for it that makes the thing nice and stable and vertical.
This is a very important part of this, you understand?
Other than that, we'll leave that loose because you're gonna reach up in there after the upper is mounted and plug that in back into the back of your speedometer.
All right, one hole that I actually forgot to drill to the correct size is a little union between the upper and the mid. There's the little hidden piece that will be covered by that black beauty piece. Kind of how you attach it is really up to you. Definitely don't want to use a Zeus fastener or something that thick right there. You could. I think there's enough room with that beauty piece. But something simpler and cheaper is, you know, one of the little black push pins. There's some that you might be able to use that are up in the upper fairing. You need something that's got a little bit more depth than that for these two pieces. So you want to drill that to size and join it.
This is the real deal.
Something like that. No interruptions. All right, now with our upper mid lower combo other mid mounted, main mounting point that you center up on is the one on the tank. Now we're going to go to the front to those reference holes, and the upper stay has a lot of wiggle room in it. So basically when you mount an upper stay, you can actually move it a couple millimeters one way or another. You can also do the same thing with the motor. So this will change the mounting points on the, basically where the mirrors were before. So the pre-drilled holes will be a reference point. I'll take a Sharpie and kind of outline where I want to open up the holes so it'll fit down over the reference point hole. And again, with the uni bit, you can kind of go left, right, or whatever as you're opening it up, and basically open it up
and keep it still a nice round hole. So we're going to make our marks there, go ahead and open those holes up, and then continue on.
All right, after we've located our holes up front and everything's tidy up there, move to the final mounting point of your upper and lower combo, and which is the lower mounts. Now, this can shift.
That's exactly correct.
Mounted hundreds of sets of bodywork of hundreds of brands, this particular mounting position is always variable. So as long as your upper is straight and true, you want this to be the last one in the chain of events, but it can vary a lot. Just because any mechanic will tell you, when they mount the motor, especially one that's hung like this, it has a lot of wiggle room in it. You can actually move some of the bikes, you can mount a motor a couple mil in one direction. And just think, if you mounted something 2 mil different in the motor here, how much different it is at the end. So basically, once you get down to the last one, you take that pre-drilled locating hole and just kind of verify where it is. Take a Sharpie and mark it. You might want to move it back one way or another. And you can do that by using your uni bit and slowly walking it to the left, right, up or down or whatever. But you want to get dead nut center in that hole. So when you go to mount this thing up, basically it goes straight in there. All right, let's move on to this mid beauty piece cover deal using the stock piece. This thing's got so many mounting points, it's ridiculous. So basically got two of the rubber nipple tipples that are on the tank there. Obviously go ahead and leave those. Another one is back here at the very tail of the tank. I would not even bother with that.
Pointless.
Just make a hole so you don't have to cut off the tip, because you're going to bolt a hard screw right into the frame right there. There's no way that thing's going to come off. This is the only one that I would probably go ahead and take the stock rubber receiver off of the stock bodywork and go ahead and stick it there. Just because it kind of wraps around in there, and you don't want that thing flapping around. After all that is mounted, popped in there like so, we're going to locate the top portion of it and grab our Sharpie or a scribe and make a mark there, which is going to be another point that, basically, unless you fling this thing off a mountain, this piece of bodywork will never come loose.
That's exactly correct.
There is a little bit of an option here on the top corner. See, there's a little bit of a cutout L shape here. You might want to move that up a little bit or cut a notch for that piece. Or, if it's a race bike, just delete that piece.
Like, pointless.
Again, you're going to have another mounting point up front here, and it's kind of getting redundant for this little piece, but a couple options. So let's go ahead and open this one up. Make sure there's nothing behind there. Including your fingers. So, deal. A little flat blade screwdriver will do the trick. Alright. Feel in the back, make sure that you're nice and flush in the back too. Then it's a little easier, like I said, SC1, Honda polish, spit on if you're into that. Makes it nice and clean. It also makes these little things pop in so nice and easy.
This is the real deal.
that hole with it off the bike, just because I don't like drilling right next to the tank. Let's open her up.
All right, let's move on to the front fender. With this, you're gonna obviously use the locating positions in stock form. You can take off the little T-nut that is in the stock one, in the stock fender that is, and use that. It's a great little piece. It'll follow through the backside and keep it from over-tightening. Same thing, the front actually has those little collars that we're talking about. It keeps it from exploding the bodywork, or the fiberglass that is. We'll just leave that on our stock safety reflector mount for reference sake. Open these things right up in the center. Same size as that little collar. There you go. All those holes are exact. Let's mount that fender. All right, let's use those T-nuts. I'm going to slide them through the inside there. Just like the stock one would.
That sounds good.
Stock mount for the factory air wing there. Mount that up loosely so you can locate the rear. Started by hand. Simple. Do the same to the other side. Bolt that thing down and it's done. Alright. Before we finish this thing up, move out to the back end of the tail. I'll usually go back across and just make sure that, you know, if this thing's running an aftermarket handlebar, you've got enough clearance in here for that handlebar or the lever. Make sure that as you tap around, it's not coming in contact with anything, maybe the, you know, case or something like that. Obviously, this bike still has a kickstand on it, and in the down position, it clears just fine. But if you were going to run your kickstand, you'd see where you would have to cut the back section of it out. Yeah, pretty much no modifications to it. There was one little spot on the inside reservoir for the radiator that I see it's coming in contact a little bit more than I'd like. I'll pull that out and show you guys that I'm going to relieve that. Also super common on the opposite side is relieving a space depending what kind of pipe you have. This one actually has a stock pipe on it, so it's got plenty of clearance. So there'll be no need to move that, but depending on what pipe you have, if some shorty or maybe, you know, something homemade, it is pretty normal to, after you mount it and everything's bolted up, that you see where you need to relieve it. So you obviously need a decent amount of space in between the pipe on the other side for heat reasons.
All right, got the fairing in my hand here, tilt it over to the inside edge right there, that Sharpie mark that I've accurately described. I'm going to relieve that and then I'll show you guys a picture of it when it's on the bike. All right, as promised, up underneath by the radiator reservoir, there is the slight section on the inner part that I relieved. Just a little bit,
but it now it doesn't get hung up when you put the thing on nice and tidy. All right, before we go ahead and fit this tail, the thing is tight. I mean, it fits like a glove. So
what will you do?
That being said, I have fitted over the seat, trunk, and brackets, but it is massively difficult. What I would recommend, for one, pop in your cable out of its receiver for the driver's seat, and we'll fish that through and fish it out the front. But you can either, if thing is going to be a dedicated race bike, I would definitely remove all of these, all of the bracketry here, except for the four mounting points to the tail.
You know, it's only a matter of time.
If it's ever going to go back, you can, since they're metal, you can go ahead and bend these things down. They will bend back. Obviously, it's not recommended, but it'll definitely make your life easier getting this tail on and off.
That's what we're going for here.
Tail's on. You don't have to remove it, because really there's nothing in this tail section after that. So I'm going to go ahead and relieve some of these. And you can just take them with your hand and bend them down, these little tabs. And let's see if we can get this tail mounted. All right. First boo of this is, turns out race bike tail needs a race bike mod. So your actual tail light for your battery tray, this section needs to be taken out. I'm gonna start by cutting it right behind these two mounting points right here, and trying to leave enough in there so it stays in the tail nice, and then trim it down the side so we can get it across there. Not that big a deal. Even if you did go back to a street bike eventually, these inner fenders are usually very cheap. I don't know on this specific year, but on the average they're usually like about $80, $60. Not that crazy of a thing basically, but if you're going with a race tail, it needs to be a race bike. So we're gonna go ahead and trim that, and I'll show you guys what it looks like after. All right, pretty simple mod with the Dremel. Just cut straight line in front of the port for the wires going to your tail, in front of those two mounting holes. Simple as that.
That was easy.
Off like that. Take our barrel sander and clean that up, make it nice and pretty. Doesn't have to be too exact, not too big of a deal, just because the tail suction is going to come and cover this whole thing, but this will allow us to get the tail suction on and off. All right, before we somewhat permanently install that tail, I'm not really kidding about that, let's reroute this cable real quick. So, I told you before, I went ahead and flattened the brackets right there. You can go ahead and remove them or flatten them. They're steel, you can bend them back. Not the prettiest thing. Those can stay. These really would be optimal to move, but we'll leave it there. So here is your cable for the driver's seat. So what I'm gonna do is just kind of push that down battery tray. What's going to happen, it's going to pop out underneath the subframe. Driver's seat cable, go ahead and push it down in there. You can kind of get hold of it, fish it around there. It has these little plastic receiver guides that's on it. Go ahead and hold on to those. So what we're gonna do is, after we get our mid and everything mounted, we're going to locate this so it'll be nice and tidy and you can remove your seat.
That's what we're going for here.
Look stock. So let's go ahead and put that tail on. We're gonna start by putting it on
backside, tail high. You're gonna fit it over those brackets we were talking about. Grab the front and just kind of pull it across the subframe like this. That is after you get it across those brackets that we'd really like to remove. So start over. Alright. Can't see it, but over the mounting bracket, which is right there, tail high.
This is the real deal.
I'm not kidding. Slowly push it down. You only want to go so far as enough to be able to fit this back piece in. Go ahead and pull that over the subframe there, both sides. Might hear it creak and protest.
That sounds good.
Just keep telling it, you're the boss.
That's what we're going for here.
And slowly work it.
We know it's only a matter of time.
Inch by inch down the subframe. So to say that this is a tight fit is like calling an H2 fast. It's kind of ridiculous. But just know that in any crash or maintenance for that model matter, tail's not going to come off.
That's exactly correct.
Again, a little bit of patience, maybe a pry bar or two. A little bit of muscle, a lot of luck. This thing will get on. Open that up. Build first. That's it saying it likes you. So. Those chicks in the gym, the big chicks in spandex, that's how they do it.
How great is that?
I'm so stoked. All right. Now, grab a little pointy locator. Small screwdriver or something like that, and align the screws into their spot like you actually need it, but looks good with something in the hole. I always say release cable for our driver's seat, a little plastic pop pin. You can route it to the top in between here if you want. take this pop pin and give yourself a little bit of slack, pop it into this lower mount. That, nice and sturdy, looks completely stock. Basically that thing will be hidden right there. You can reach up and relieve your seat at any time.
All right, let's get on with our final stage of assembly here. Our locating holes nice and opened up and lined up on the front fairing. Go ahead and mount our windscreen. Now with this, you can kind of glue it away, get yourself a nice mirror plate that covers it, a larger washer that covers the hole, or to be honest, you can go old school on it and throw a zip tie through it. There's so many mounting points on this fairing that a zip tie would probably be a friendly addition. So go ahead and reach up in the chin here. You can feel that plug. You're gonna have to get used to this and funnel it into the back of the gauges like that. And you hear a little click. We're lit up and ready to go. Move over to our last little body piece here. Line those up on the titties. You actually want to start with putting that little leading edge in and then snap the little tits in there in their little rubber receptacle. Line all that up nice and tidy. Little screw at the back. The front, like we were saying, you could either go with, you know, a well nut up underneath there. There's plenty of room to get your hand underneath there. We're going to use just one of those black pop pins again. Nice and light. See, we've got 17 mounting points. I don't think an extra one's necessary, so we're good with that. Shoot. Looks like we need a seat. And we are race prep, body work, and ready to ride. All right, guys, there you go. We got our race body work mounted and ready to rock. This thing's ready to hit the track. Stay tuned for all the other parts we'll be putting on plethora of 400s. This 400R gig is going to go big, and we're going to bring whatever it is to make this thing fast, cool, or functional. Yeah, stay tuned. See ya.